Get ready for action.
Buzz! Buzz Lightyear!
We're previewing the newest movies and TV shows you can't miss.
I'm a superhero.
What should those super fans know about Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Plus,
oh, goody, the murderers are here.
A sneak peek of Only Murders in the Building Season 2. Jeff Bridges' action-packed new series, The Old Man, and some very entertaining ways to celebrate Pride Month.
This is why straight people hate us.
Also, hear from the stars of The Oroville, the new Sex Pistol series, Pistol, and we'll take you to the premiere of the Bob's Burgers movie.
It's fun to feel like a movie star for a night.
On the Red Carpet starts right now.
Hello and welcome to this special June preview edition of On the Red Carpet. We have so many great new shows and movies to enjoy, including the new Star Wars show, Obi-Wan Kenobi, which you can stream on Disney Plus right now.
Leave us alone.
When the time comes, he must be trained.
Like you trained his father?
Ewan McGregor returns to his role as the legendary Jedi Master in Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Our mission was to tell this character-based story about a character we know and love from the original trilogy and from the prequels.
The six-episode series bridges the gap between Ewan's last Star Wars prequel film and the original trilogy.
More and more I hear from people that the prequels are like their Star Wars films, you know, and their relationship to my Star Wars films is like the relationship I had with Carrie Fisher and Mark Hamill and Harrison Ford's films when I was a kid.
The new series also includes the return of Hayden Christensen as Darth Vader and a new villain, Reva, played by Moses Ingram.
You can't fight Obi-Wan! You can't escape him!
Is it nice to be bad?
It's fun. It really is a good time. She doesn't believe she's bad. She thinks she's just doing a really good job at what she does. And, you know, it costs people sometimes. It costs people sometimes.
I've always thought there could be a cool story between Revenge of the Sith and A New Hope. And that's exactly what we found and developed. And I think people will feel the same way.
All right, new in movie theaters for June, Disney Pixar's Lightyear. It's the origin story of everyone's favorite space ranger who, it turns out, wasn't always a toy.
You weren't the real Buzz Lightyear, you're an action figure. You are a child's plaything.
You are a sad, strange little man, and you have my pity. Farewell.
Sorry, Buzz, but Woody was right. The brave hero we loved in four Toy Story films was not the real Buzz Lightyear, but a toy based on the real-life Space Ranger.
This Lightyear mission log, Stardate 3901. After a full year of being marooned, our first hyperspeed test flight is a go.
Who are you talking to?
No one.
You were narrating again.
I was not. Just doing the mission log.
While Tim Allen famously voiced the toy Buzz...
To infinity and beyond!
The real-life Buzz needed a different voice, and who better to play a daring space ranger than Captain America himself, Chris Evans.
Ready, Captain Lightyear?
Ready as I'll ever be, Commander Hawthorne. Buzz Lightyear to Star Command. Come in, Star Command.
Why don't they answer?
Hey!
The
robots.
The what?
In Lightyear, we'll see this Buzz teaming up with new friends on an intergalactic adventure, battling giant robots, and even the real evil Emperor Zurg. Lightyear comes out June 17th, only in theaters.
Hello, kitty kitty. I am Baymax.
And we'll see more of another animated hero as well. The big, lovable robot from Big Hero 6 returns in the new series, Baymax, streaming June 29th on Disney+.
Please remain calm. You did not remain calm.
The latest TV show from the Marvel Cinematic Universe is Ms. Marvel. The six-episode series debuting on Disney+ is one the whole family can get behind.
Kamala.
Kamala.
Another Avengers shirt. Cute.
She thinks I'm some kind of weirdo.
You are a weirdo.
Newcomer Iman Vellani plays Kamala Khan, aka Ms. Marvel, a teen from Jersey City who has a passion for the MCU, and then gets special powers of her own.
Did something happen to you?
No, why? Did you hear something?
Kamala?
I think that we really want to grab the attention of teenage girls and show them that they, you know, have the potential to be great and have that power just like Kamala does. And there's a huge diverse group of characters, so I think everybody will find somebody to connect to.
Do you know what you are?
I'm a superhero.
Ms. Marvel is just one more amazing character that more people, whether based on their ethnicity, whether based on their age, based on their life experience, they can identify with her.
Ms. Marvel hits Disney Plus June 8th.
Goody, the murderers are here.
Over on Hulu, Steve Martin, Martin Short, and Selena Gomez return for season 2 of Hulu's most watched comedy of all time, Only Murders in the Building. This season, they have a new murder case to solve, but the three of them are among the top suspects. New episodes will be released each week, beginning June 28th.
It's really hard with Kanye.
When the Kardashians premiered on Hulu this year, it shattered the record as Hulu's biggest series premiere ever in the U.S. We'll see if Kris, Courtney, Kim, Khloe, Kendall, and Kylie can top that when their season finale drops on June 16th. Also on Hulu, the Pioneers of Punk. Oscar-winning director Danny Boyle brings us the saga of the Sex Pistols in Pistol. It's the music at the forefront of the 1970s punk rock movement. Coming to Hulu on May 31st, Pistol is a limited series from FX tracking the meteoric rise and fall of the infamous Sex Pistols. Anson Boone plays the band's intense lead singer, Johnny Rotten.
It was exhausting, but there's a lot of adrenaline that comes with being on stage, and that was my fuel, really, and it was so important and so helpful, and I'm sure John used to channel that as well.
The band hit star status and then self-destructed relatively quickly, but not before changing music, fashion, and art forever. Telling their whole story is the goal for Oscar-winning director Danny Boyle.
When I was 19, the Sex Pistols changed my life, really, changed the world I lived in.
And when it comes to the music in this series, it was Pistols, punk, or nothing.
You can't say, well, we can't play that, but we'll play this. You've got to play the real stuff. So I wouldn't have done it if we didn't have the music.
I was lying in my room and the news came on TV.
Hollywood star girl also puts music front and center. Grace VanderWaal is back in this sequel to 2020's Stargirl.
Life is very surprising and it throws you a lot of curveballs, and the only thing you can do is roll with it and just see what happens.
The young singer and her mom, played by Judy Greer, are taking on the bright lights and big dreams of Hollywood. This free-spirited teen crosses paths with a variety of eclectic characters, including her musical idol, played by Uma Thurman.
You're gonna have to figure out your own thing.
Hollywood star girl lands on Disney Plus on June 3rd. On the red carpet is celebrating Pride Month this June. Here's Ellen Leyva with a preview.
Hi, George. I'm excited to host the LA Pride Parade coverage. Even if you're not in LA, you can watch the celebration on Hulu. And there's a lot more great entertainment coming this Pride Month as well.
This week is sacred. We're going to Fire Island.
And this is why straight people hate us.
Fire Island is being called an unapologetic modern-day rom-com. Inspired by Jane Austen's Pride and Prejudice, it tells the story of an eclectic group of friends having a legendary week-long adventure.
You want some whiskey? It would help with your knees. You trust me, I'm a doctor.
Fire Island premieres June 3rd on Hulu. Then on June 15th, we'll see the third and final season of Hulu's groundbreaking coming-of-age series, Love, Victor.
Mom? Dad? I'm gay.
Season 2 of Love, Victor earned a perfect 100 score on Rotten Tomatoes, and season 3 promises to be even better. On Freeform, another show featuring a queer love story at its center, Motherland, Fort Salem, is also entering its third and final season. The show, which takes place in an alternate reality where witches are real, returns June 21st. Disney Junior will feature episodes highlighting representation and acceptance on shows like Doc McStuffins and the GLAAD Award-nominated Fancy Nancy and Muppet Babies. On Disney Plus, Trevor the Musical premieres June 24th, a film stage production based on the Oscar-winning short Trevor, which inspired the Trevor Project.
Don't pretend any of them are something they're not.
And also for musical fans, every episode of Glee starts streaming on Disney Plus and Hulu beginning June 1st.
Coming up,
fresh hot burgers, sexy burgers.
The world premiere of the Bob's Burgers movie. Plus, new heroes and new villains coming to Disney Channel. And why you shouldn't mess with Jeff Bridges or his dogs in The Old Man. Want more entertainment news? Follow On the Red Carpet on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok.
Drop it on Disney Plus to see all your favorites.
Head to Hulu to watch the latest hits, movies.
Hop by ESPN Plus to catch a game.
Or an original.
Looking for your next streaming destination?
Come to Bundletown.
Get the Disney Bundle, only $13.99 a month.
The Bob's Burgers movie is here, and it's served with a side of good old-fashioned family fun.
Ta-da! Fresh hot burgers, sexy burgers.
Len.
Why?
Now in theaters, the Bob's Burgers movie is a hot and fresh take on one of animation's favorite families. The Belchers jump to the big screen for a combo platter of entertainment with music, comedy, and adventure. And all because of the fans.
Oh, our fans are so sweet and loving and and really kind and smart. And yeah, I think they probably sort of willed it to be more than anyone else.
Disney Channel has some new offerings for June, and it's all about using your power for good or not so good.
Remind me where you're from again.
Toronto.
We are on the run, and we have to be living as normal people so we don't get caught and just killed.
The rest of the Maddens still kind of have that inclination to cause a little bit of mischief and, you know, and cause some trouble because they've been villains their whole lives.
We have standards and practices to contend with, so the trouble is never going to be life-threatening.
Villains of Valley View, hijinks it up on the Disney Channel June 3rd.
The mask chose me. Whoa, that is full on magic! Let's see what I can do.
Also premiering June 3rd, right after Villains, is Ultraviolet and Black Scorpion, about a teenage girl named Violet who turns into an unlikely superhero.
She comes across this magical luchador mask that gives her this superpower, this ability that she has to kind of learn how to use.
I'm going to be fighting crime with none other than the city's best vigilante superhero, Black Scorpion.
Black Scorpion, or Cruz, has to teach her really how to use this mask responsibly and, you know, how to help people, but also to do it, you know, for the sake of the people and not really herself.
Also on the Disney Channel, Bunked is back for a sixth season. The Wild Adventures of Campers and Counselors will premiere June 10th. Also on Disney Channel, Disney's Summer Magic Quest premieres June 26th. Yvette Nicole Brown will host as the stars of Zombies 3 compete in some wild challenges through Epcot at Walt Disney World. Now to our Tony Cabrera with what's coming our way from Disney Junior.
George, as you can tell, my kids are Disney Junior super fans. Right, kids?
Yeah!
And lucky for me, I mean them, the network has a lot more great programming lined up for June.
On the red carpet at Disneyland, happiest place.
Singing's always on the menu at the happiest place on earth, especially at this event celebrating all the magic of Disney Junior.
I was so honored to be invited, and I'm so excited.
Down the rabbit hole to Wonderland.
Libby Rue is Alice from Alice's Wonderland Bakery, a new take on the classic fairy tale adventure. The show's renewed for a second season and is still premiering new season one episodes in June.
It's such a fun show. They go on adventures all around Wonderland, baking and having fun.
I play Harry the March Hare, and in this, he is a designer.
Is there a voice?
There is a voice. It has a little bit of Oprah in it. But he's very fabulous. He's having a great time.
Eureka, 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 Eureka.
Also having a great time, the Eureka Family, premiering on June 22nd. The show is about an extraordinary young girl who thinks way out of the box in hopes of taking her prehistoric world to the next level.
She's an inventor. She's a very caring girl. She's very powerful. She's just a wonderful character that is just trying to make a difference.
Still ahead, Oscar winner Jeff Bridges' new action drama. And Oscar winner Emma Thompson's sexiest role ever.
Is Leo Grand your real name?
Plus, a pair of powerful new shows marking 50 years of Title IX.
We are celebrating the monumental civil rights journey of women across the sports and cultural landscape.
And a celebrity chef saving the world one meal at a time.
Oscar winner Jeff Bridges is someone you don't want to mess with in the new FX drama, The Old Man.
Any more you send it, ma'am, send them back in bags. Anyone you send it, my kid, send them back in pieces.
Jeff Bridges is an ex-CIA operative who spent decades living off the grid, but is now being hunted by the FBI's assistant director, played by John Lithgow.
This is not something to underestimate.
The Old Man also stars Amy Brenneman.
What is happening?
And two very loyal dogs. It premieres June 16th on FX and streams the next day on Hulu.
Remember that I love you, that I'll always love you.
FX will also premiere a new comedy, The Bear, about a young chef's return from the fine dining world to run his family's no-frills beef sandwich shop in Chicago. Actress and singer Sophia Carson has been busy promoting the release of her self-titled debut album, which is available now. Up next, we'll see Sophia hosting an important television event marking the 50th anniversary of Title IX, Our America 50-50.
Imagine not being able to play your favorite sport growing up. How would that have changed your childhood?
Our America 50-50 will highlight the incredible impact of Title IX, which guaranteed girls and women equal opportunities in school sports.
We are celebrating the monumental civil rights journey of women across the sports and cultural landscape.
You can watch Our America 50-50 on your local ABC station or on Hulu and ESPN+. And also on ESPN+ this June.
Do you think people know what Title IX is?
A new docuseries, 37 Words, showing the lasting impact of Title IX. Just 37 words written into federal law that changed women's rights forever.
We wanted to make sure that any girl born in this world would have a place to compete.
They said I didn't belong.
Basketball star Giannis Antetokounmpo is a perfect example of how sports can change lives. He grew up a poor, undocumented kid in Greece and became a two-time NBA MVP. His remarkable story, now the subject of a new movie, Rise, streaming on Disney Plus June 24th.
Papa always talks about opportunity. What if this is it?
Not only did Giannis make it to the NBA, his two brothers did as well, all three of them becoming NBA champions. Meanwhile, a new NBA champion is about to be crowned, part of a huge June for sports fans. Here's Rob Fukuzaki with more.
George, ABC will be the network of champions this June. It all starts with the NBA Finals exclusively on ABC. Game one, Thursday, June 2nd, and that also means the return of Jimmy Kimmel Game Night. Meanwhile, this year's NHL champion will be crowned on ABC as well. That's right, the Stanley Cup Final will also be on ABC this June. And if that wasn't enough for hockey fans...
This is who I am, but when it comes to game time, I'm ready to turn it on.
Don't miss new episodes of Quest for the Stanley Cup, providing incredible access inside the dressing rooms and beyond with this year's playoff teams on ESPN+. You'll also see five MLS soccer games on ABC this June. And fight fans, get ready for more UFC on ABC as well. Then on June 23rd, the next NBA stars will arrive in style at the NBA Draft, which you can watch live from the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. On ABC and ESPN. George?
Thank you, Rob. Turning now to programming you could say nourishes the soul. It's We Feed People, directed by Ron Howard.
Take a look. We're going through very high water.
Jose Andres will do anything to get food to those who need it.
For me, it was very clear that I wanted to create an organization that we will be able to respond to events that disturbs the lives of people.
And in We Feed People, we see just what it takes for Andres World Central Kitchen to make sure those in need get fed.
This was the spirit of this entire documentary, and I think it shows.
I definitely shows, but what I'm most excited about is it's not only what we could cover, it's the origin story of this organization.
We Feed People is streaming now on Disney Plus.
I feel like she's Jesus.
Freeform has a new docuseries you'll want to dive into called The Deep End. It looks inside the world of one of today's most controversial spiritual leaders and her dedicated followers. Catch up now on Freeform and Hulu.
Up next,
you're the only adventure I've ever had.
Emma Thompson's sexy new role. Plus, General Hospital celebrates another incredible milestone.
I'm Leo. You must be Nancy. May I come inside?
Yes.
That's Oscar winner Emma Thompson as a retired school teacher on a journey of sexual exploration in Good Luck to You, Leo Grand. Emma's character seeks the help of a charming young sex worker, and together they find a surprising human connection. It premieres June 17th on Hulu. And a big congratulations to ABC's General Hospital, which is set to air its 15,000th episode on Friday, June 17th. A major milestone like that calls for a major celebration. And I was on the set for just that.
Well, I don't think anybody can believe that it's been on this long. It's quite an accomplishment, isn't it?
It certainly is. General Hospital debuted in 1963. Jeannie Francis joined in the late 1970s, and while she's taken breaks here and there, she always comes back to what she calls family.
It is a very warm place to be, and for me, it's home. What can I say? It's home.
This special episode will center around her character, Laura, who is the mayor of the fictional Port Charles.
I feel really proud, just so proud to be, and honored, really, that they focus on my character to do this for this 15,000th episode. It's a family and all the memories, and it just feels good to have everybody get together, and everybody's here today.
Love her, and love you for watching. For all the latest entertainment news, be sure to follow On the Red Carpet on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok. We'll see you next time on the Red Carpet.